Уже шумят трибуны рядовой арены. Привет, здравствуйте! Привет, великолепная земля! 22-й чемпионат мира по кикбоксу в Челябинске набирает обороты! Сегодня вас ожидают полуфиналы и сразу в трех весовых категориях. Женщины до 53 и свыше 73 килограмм, и мужчины до 54. За кого сегодня болеем? Челябинск! За Ольгу Иванову, ты прав, друг, дай 5! Я поприветствую тебя лично! Молодец, что пришел, наверное, не один сегодня? Всей семьей? Молодец, что пришел, как тебя зовут? Андрей, давайте Андрею поаплодируем! Который бросил все дела, ведет все встречи. Этот малыш пришел сегодня поболеть за Ольгу! Красоту русскую! Давайте девушкам поаплодируем, которые сегодня под сводами ледовой арены «Трактор». Мужчины! Привет, мужчины Южного Урала! Говорят, Челябинск суровый край, вранье. Давайте улыбнемся! Улыбнемся всему миру! Раскроем гостеприимные объятия! И громко крикнем самую главную фразу. Вперед, Россия! Трибуна «Мамы» готовы гнать Россию вперед, требовать побед сегодня, золото! Так хочется золота в копилку сборной! 3-4 кричит, что трибуна «Мамы» вперед, Россия! 3-4! Можно еще громче! 3-4! Вот молодцы, еще громче! 3-4! Вперед! Я думаю, можно еще громче, кто-то промолчал на счет три. Вперед, Россия! Раз, два, три! И еще раз!
Hi, Christopher. Try again. Oh, hello, how you doing? Okay, this is microphone number one, Michael McKenzie speaking.
Luke Cook on mic number two.
Я хочу эту футболку запустить. Кто танцует, подстригивайте!
Hello and welcome to the 2015 WTF World Taekwondo Championships here in the very impressive Traktor Arena, Chelyabinsk, Russia. Over 130 countries from around the world have brought their athletes in the hope of seeing them crowned world champions. Today is the fifth day of competition and the fourth day of medal-winning matches. Today's semi-finals and finals are in the female minus 53 kilogram division, the female plus 73 kilogram division, and the male minus 54 kilogram division. The preliminary rounds were contested yesterday. As you can see on your screen there, the international referees are just making their way into the stadium. And once they're in position, the matches will get underway. Just while we're waiting for referees to get into position, I'll introduce my co-commentator tonight, Luke Cook. Luke, you're looking forward to some good matches this evening?
Yeah, definitely looking forward to tonight's event. We'll see. My brother's girlfriend, Bianca's in the medal stage, so I'll be cheering her on, hoping she can take that world title. And there's obviously, we're blessed to see previous world champions as well, Croatia's Anna Saninovic. Who else do we have tonight?
There's some great players. We've got Yuwen Huang from Chinese Taipei, who's the 2014 Asian Games champion and the world student champion, who's successfully made the transition to seniors. So she'll be playing Anna Zelenovic from Croatia in the first match. Zelenovic got the silver medal here last time in the World Championships in 2013, and before that in 2011 was world champion. So that will be the first match that they'll be on. We've also got Lim Gumbyol from Korea, silver world champion in 2014, and Andrea Asproger-Karaka from Greece in the second semi-final of the 53 kilograms. So we've got some great action today. It'll be difficult to top the final that we had last night with Russian Alex Denisenkov and the great Servet Tazigul, so hopefully we'll see a repeat of that sort of action. That was an incredible final last night. Federation World Championships held here in Russia for the very first time. Day five's evening session. So the introductions are going on in the arena. We can see the athletes in the holding area. Finals has just about gone live. Announcements have been made. Приближается к концу пятый день соревнований. И совсем скоро мы проведем 6 полуфинальных и 3 финальных поединка на звание чемпионов мира. We have 1,000 athletes made their way here to Russia. 139 different countries hoping to pick up those valuable ranking points. Olympic champions and world champions. As this week we crown 16 brand new world champions. В чемпионате участвуют более 1000 спортсменов из 139 стран. Олимпийские чемпионы борются за звание одного из 16 новых чемпионов мира. Вчера мы уже узнали имена 6 двух новых чемпионов. So, who are our world champions? We've got 6 so far crowned over the past 3 nights. From Korea, Park Min-ah. From the Islamic Republic of Iran, Masoud Haji Zabaray and Fazab Ashur Zadeh Balad. From Thailand, Hanipak Won Patapanakit, which I can now say very easily. Chinese Taipei, Chang Chia Chia. And from Turkey, great final last night, wasn't it? Servet Tazigul.
Итак, за время чемпионата мы уже узнали имена 6 новых чемпионов мира. Из Кореи – Камин Ан, из Ирана – Мусад Хаджи Заваре, Фарзаб Ашур Затек Палем из Ирана, Панипак Ванг Патанакит из Таиланда, Чуан Чиа Чиа из китайского Тайбэя, Сервет Тазигюль из Турции.
So, tonight's semi-finals. We have from Chinese Taipei, Huang Yun Wei. From Croatia, Anna
Зелинович. Сегодня в женских полуфинальных поединках весовой категории до 53 килограмм сражаются Куань Юнь Вэнь, китайский Тайбэй, против Анны Зинанович из Хорватии.
From Korea we have Lin Jeong Bio, and from Greece Adriana Astrogiraka.
Lin Im Pyo, Korea, против Adriana Astrogiraka, Греция.
From Turkey we have Nafia Kus against from Great Britain Bianca Walkden.
В женской весовой категории свыше 73 килограмм Нафия Кус, Турция, против Бьянки Уолкин, Великобритания.
From France we have Gladys Ipongue against the Russian Federation Olga Ivanova.
Гладис Ипонг из Франции против Ольги Ивановой из России.
And from Brazil, Vanilton Teixeira against, once again, here we go, from Russia, we have Stanislav Denisov!
В мужской весовой категории до 54 килограмм. Vanilton Teixeira, Бразилия, против Станислава Денисова из России.
From Thailand, we have Ramanong Sawikawahari against, from Korea, Kim Tae-hoon.
Рамнарон Савакбихара, Таиланд, против Ким Хэ Чун, Корея.
We are 2 minutes away from welcoming our athletes into the arena. So, Челябинск, make some noise!
Челябинск, мы начинаем!
And you can see they're just in the top of your picture there. The international referees are about to take their place on the contest area.
This is the 22nd of the BTF World Taekwondo Championships. And this is a good evening to Chelyabinsk. This event is brought to you in association with the WTF and beyond. The WTF partners, Kuki Wong and Dayday.
Это 22-й чемпионат мира по Тэквондо. И в этом году мы горячо приветствуем вас, Челябинске. Чемпионат проходит при поддержке Всемирной Федерации Тэквондо, губернатора Челябинской области и компании «Буян». Партнеры Всемирной Федерации Тэквондо – Куки Вон и Тайду.
The event partners are the Ministry of Sport for the Russian Federation, the Governor of Chelyabinsk Region, the Russian Taekwondo Federation and the Chelyabinsk Regional Taekwondo Federation, Taishan Sports Industry Group.
Партнеры чемпионата – Министерство спорта Российской Федерации, Союз Тэквондо России, Федерация Челябинской области, Тайшань Спортс Индустри Групп.
Right, that's the introductions completed, so the match will get underway shortly. From Chinese Taipei, we have Yun Wen Wang in blue and Anna Zananovic from Croatia in red. Yun Wen Wang is 20 years old. In 2014, she was the Asian Games champion and the World Student Champion. She's a student at Taiwan University and a member of the Taichuang Taekwondo team. She's making a very successful transition into the senior category at the female minus 53, and she's managed to get some considerable scalps under her belt to get here to the final tonight. And she'll be up against one of the Croatian twins, Anna Zananovic, 27 years old. In 2014, she was a European champion. As we just said earlier on, she won a silver at last World Championships in 2013, and the one before that, she went one better and was world champion. She'll be keen to take back that title. She's recovering from an elbow injury where she had surgery. She actually had the surgery at Christmas, as that was the only time she could fit into the busy schedule. She made a full recovery now. And she's the identical twin of Lucia Zananovic, we'll be seeing later in the championships.
As the athletes enter the court, Kelly Vince for the first time with athletes in the arena, make some noise!
And there you can see the video, you can see the transmitters from the trunk protectors, the protective scoring system being put in place. Here looking quite calm and confident, ranked number four in the world, Olympic ranking system. Just doing the compulsory testing there to make sure the protective scoring system, the PSS, is working fine. That scores kicks to the body, and the new PSS head guards that you've just seen them put on now, they score impacts to the actual, that make contact on the actual head guard. In the case of the kick to the face, then the judges will score those techniques. Right, Susanna Mitchell from Canada, the referees, get this match underway. Zanovic going up for the head, parrying away the body kick and then trying to go over the top. Taipei kicks into the body but didn't quite connect. Going to need to be careful with these clashing of legs. He will get penalised for that probably later on in the match. Zanovic goes high again, yeah, just weighing out, measuring the range and distance. Quite happy right now holding that centre ground. The Taipei goes high, goes for the first kick. She's indicating to a coach to appeal, but he knows the impact was to the head guard. It didn't register, so that would be a wasted card. Not a good idea so early on in the match.
Yeah, definitely not. You want to save those video replays into something probably a bit more.
Definitely, yeah.
Last 30 seconds maybe.
I've seen some really good use of the video replay by coaches, but very rarely do we see it this early on unless there's a very, very clear shot. We don't want to waste that opportunity, or the coaches don't want to waste that opportunity of making a viable appeal later on in the match. So 0-0. Wang from Chinese Taipei, Zanovic from Croatia. The first final here at the 22nd World Championships, the minus 53 kilogram female division. We have a low kick there by the Croatian. Taipei goes high, just ducks out of the way. Nice counter back kick there by Zanovic, didn't score. Taipei did well to cover up. A lot of athletes trying the punching. That is scored by the judges, so there's a higher chance of scoring with the punch. That's the first round completed. No points scored. Luke, what do you make of that?
I mean, it's what we've seen for the first few days. First round of the semi-finals, so just sussing each other out. Don't need to open up too dramatic. I would imagine, even though the Taipei athlete is seeded number one here, obviously we know that Zinovich has dropped through the rankings, being out from that injury. She hasn't probably had the preparation as she would have preferred coming into the World Championships. So it's probably a bit closer. Maybe you could arguably say that Anna's probably world number two.
Well, look at the form, but the history. On the rankings, she might be lower down because she hasn't been competing, but a former world champion and silver. This is the third time she's actually been in the final of the World Championships.
Yeah.
So she's not going to be fazed by that. She looked very confident and composed in that first round. So as much as there were doing that foot fencing off the front leg, Zanovic was trying to go high. She did try a back kick as well, so the rankings, you know, she would probably feel quite comfortable at this stage and not be too phased by the seedings.
She's going to be phased by that. 6-0 down. Double impact on the head guard. But she used her experience very well yesterday. She was in two really close fought matches against Kazakhstan and then, I believe it was China. And she used that world championship experience to come through those matches in those last seconds.
Can't go there for Zelenovic yet. 6-1 behind right now.
And there's still a long way to go in this match. We haven't even reached the halfway point yet. But it's 5 points isn't unassailable.
Zelenovic followed in with a kick to the body. Yeah, just to explain the scoring system, a kick to the body or a punch to the body is worth 1 point. A kick to the head is worth 3 points. If it's a rotating or spinning kick to the body, it's worth 3 points, and a rotating kick to the head is worth 4 points. So, although a 5 point deficit... Oh, another headshot. Another headshot by Taipei. I was just about to say a single headshot doesn't make that much difference, but then the Taipei goes and extends the lead.
And Anna just scored her second punch.
Well, she needs higher scoring techniques than the basic punch.
She has it in her arsenal. We all know Anna's very dangerous, especially with the back kicks, which are now worth 3 points in 2015. Previously, in previous years, only worth the 2 points.
So 7 points behind now for Zelenovic, coming to the last 30 seconds of the first round. Second round, she needs to she'll feel a lot happier if she's got something back before the end. Goes in for the strong punch again. Didn't score that time. So in the first round we saw Zelenovic going high and not quite impacting. And then Huang from Chinese Taipei has been successfully hit the head 3 times now, which has given her a 7 point lead. She'll be very happy at that at this stage. Yeah, Zelenovic will be feeling quite a bit different from the first break after the first round. Be interesting to see how the Taipei athlete tries to control this round, whether she fights negatively to spoil the Croatians' attempts at getting back, or whether she stays competitive.
Well, she definitely won't be putting herself in too much danger, that's for sure. She'll be trying to tick away the clock as much as she can.
But she did score those kicks so well, so comfortably. It's a risk for Zelenovic that when she attacks Wang, that she could get countered and get kicked in the head trying to come in there. So she has to be cautious. First 30 seconds, pretty cautious, do you think, Luke? And then a little bit explosive action like we've seen in the other finals towards the last minute?
No, I'm pretty sure Anna's going to have to pretty much push. She's 7 points down. The Croatian coach would have been G'ing her up for this final 2 minutes, see what she can produce.
Just kicking off the foot leg still.
Wang's been the aggressor, though.
Nice reverse kick there, up to the head.
It's a nice attempt, just falling short. Those are the kind of techniques she needs to be trying.
That would have been worth 4 points if she'd have made impact on the head guard. Goes for the punch again. It's a very strong punch that she has. Huang from Taipei goes high to the head there.
Scored that punch. That brings the gap down to 6.
But Wang's definitely not playing a spoiling game. She's trying to get her own kicks in. There we saw a kick, what we call a scorpion kick, going up to the head. Blue gets a warning for holding. The kick doesn't make the contact. Zelenovic tries to spin in, but stops the movement short. Wang starts to move around a bit more now. She's still taking it to the Croatian.
Active defense, just being the aggression, putting Anna under the pressure, making it difficult for her to come forward with her own attacks.
So we're in the last minute now, and Anna Zelenovic, the world silver medalist from 2013, needs to do some work here to close down that gap of 6 points. Goes for the strong punch again. Wang's not having any of it.
There's a back kick of her own there. I think that's pretty much the match. A 9 point gap now, 40 seconds.
That back kick probably is the deciding technique of the match. The 20-year-old Taipei girl, who was the Asian Games champion, has now made the transition up to the seniors and looks like she's going to make it to the final.
Anna has to take some chances now. She's got any hope of getting into this final with 20 seconds left. She's got to be trying the four-point techniques.
The Kyongo there making it 12-4, but still 8 points to get. Now we can see the Taipei athlete closing down. Susanna Mitchell not having any of it. The Canadian referee gives another warning. Zanovic still working, still pushing forwards, but not scoring enough.
Last few seconds.
Wang. Credit to Yuan Wang. She's continued attacking, continued working all the time through that match. Managed to overpower Anna Zanovic. That first kick was a double contact to the head, which made the difference, gave that six-point gap, and then she just built on that. Zanovic wasn't able to answer. So Anna Zanovic from Croatia, former world champion and silver medalist, completes the set, and this year will take a bronze medal. The coach there seems to begin with still more coaching information. I don't know whether that was encouragement or criticism. It was a tough match. She did work very hard. She was constantly pushing forwards. That's the double impact to the right at the beginning of the first round. That was a second. That was a third technique. So not a bad semi-final start us off. We did see the cautious start like we would expect. Nobody wants to give away points in the semi-finals at the World Championships, but plenty of action, plenty of attempts at the reverse kicks, plenty of headshots. Let's hope the next final semi-final lives up to that. Gumbyol Lim from Korea versus Aspro Geraka from Greece. Two young athletes. Lim from Korea took a silver at the Junior World Championships last year. Another Korean athlete that's been had a lot of focus and coaching on, looking for the future. Aspro Geraka from Greece was the European under 21 champion in 2014. Earlier this year, she took a bronze at the Greek Open. So two quite young athletes in this second semi-final of the minus 53 kilogram division at the World Championships here at the Traktor Arena in Chelyabinsk, Russia. Introductions are being made. Referees are in position already.
Quite nervous there, actually. Doesn't look like someone that's quite happy about going out to a semi-final of the World Championships. Maybe she's very focused, thinking about her game plan against this young Greek athlete.
I think you can't help but think about the next match as well. If you were to win this semi-final, then they're up against an athlete from Chinese Taipei who's skillfully confident, got her headshots in, also covered really well so that her opponent couldn't get through a defense, which we've seen a trait with all the Chinese Taipei athletes during this championships. Doesn't seem overly confident, the Korean athlete, with her head down like that, moving into the competition area.
The Korea, I think they haven't had the starts of the World Championships as they would have hoped. Obviously, they are the world leading medalist all time in World Championships. But they haven't had it all their own way, certainly in recent years. And certainly at this World Championships. I was wondering if the Greece can take another Korean scalp.
Yeah, it will be interesting. Obviously, later on this evening, we've got Taeyun Kim from Korea, who's a 2013 world champion, is one of their top athlete, current athletes this time. So they've got two here. So not bad going for a nation, but Korea used to dominate just about every semi-final at the World Championship. So the rest of the world catching up now, especially as we saw in the first 2 days, Iran in the men's categories. Turkey's always done well. They've already taken two medals, a gold and a silver so far, and they've got medalists in the semi-final today in the plus 73 kilogram division against Bianca Morgan from Great Britain. So those are the sort of dominant nations we're seeing right now at this World Championships.
Yeah, well, Korea definitely under pressure. They've only ever lost the male standings one time, to Iran in 2011.
11, I think it was, yeah.
And I think they're definitely under pressure after the first 2 days when Iran took two goals out of two male weight divisions.
Well, this is a female category, the minus 53 kilogram division. Lim Gumbyol of Korea in blue versus Andrea Asprogaraka from Greece in red. A world silver medalist from 2014 against the European under 21 champion from 2014. Coming, changing stance there, coming off the front leg again. Cuts over the top of their opponent then. Kicks into the body.
Yeah, she's just trying to loop over the Greece's leading front leg and then reach in to the open paddock, that, like she's just done there successfully. Takes the lead 1-0.
That could be a value point so early on in the in this contest.
Certainly be a psychological point. First point on the board always helps. There's a second. Greece still looking for their first one to help her settle into the final.
Andrea hasn't looked like scoring yet from the Greek athlete. She's used that cautious attempt moving forwards. A headshot there by Lim.
Andreana just ducked underneath that one.
The print does look like more likely to go high over the top of the Greeks' attack. Comes off the back leg for the counter. Korean definitely playing a reactionary game. Waiting for a Greek athlete to attack and then pick her off. Good kick into the body there, it scores. Very clear kick. Gives her a 3-point lead now, just as this round comes to the end. Goes high. So the Korean athlete will be quite happy with that. Lim, she's taken 3 points. Andreana has not looked like scoring as yet.
Doesn't look like she's having any access to Korea's attacks. I'll imagine she'll probably play the same kind of game plan in the second round. Maybe she can get a little bit lucky. She has found some impact on the pad, but just not registering enough.
Well, all her attacks have been off the front leg, so possibly she needs to shoot off the back leg to, maybe on the counter to score. Lots of athletes scared of doing that at these early stages of the match because they don't want to leave themselves open to be countered themselves. But Andreana from Greece hasn't really looked like scoring. She hasn't registered hard enough. She needs to do more than what she has done in this first round, or we are going to see the Korean athlete get into the final of the World Championships against Wang from Taipei. the second round. And in switching stances. They're still both open, comes up, then she comes off the back leg. She has got a slight height advantage, the Korean athlete. She has longer legs and longer reach, so she's more comfortably kicking higher. She hasn't made a headshot as yet. The 3 points that she has are through three separate kicks.
The Korean is constantly changing stances. It's quite interesting. Greece seems committed to that one side, just using her right leg.
Well, it's not worked for her as yet, and she's halfway through the second round. Korean athlete more mobile as well. Again, shooting high. And again.
A headshot there.
That's it. And again, we're seeing a 6 point lead. Not seen anything from Andreana to look like she's got an answer to the Korean athlete.
Another point there for Korea. 7-0 now.
She needs to change the game plan. The Greek athlete tries her punch. The kicking, she followed him that punch with a kick which registered, but it wasn't powerful enough to score. So currently it looks like a Taipei Korea final in the minus 53 kilogram division.
There is the opportunity for Greece to throw a back kick. The Korean athlete does seem to open herself up quite a lot when she's changing her stances, but she doesn't seem to be pouncing on that opportunity. Maybe the confidence has dropped, being 7 points down, but she needs to take some chance. Start believing.
That's the first point she's registered there in that exchange. When she does move like that, she seems faster than the Korean athlete, so she has got the ability to get back into this match, but she needs to be doing something very early on in the third round.
That 1 point might just give her a bit of confidence. The coach should gear up. In this last round, Andreana's going to have to push. But I think she's going to ultimately end up walking onto a couple of Korean head kicks.
That's the risk, isn't it? If you are trying to get those points back, you have to be more aggressive, you have to move forwards more, which leaves you open to counter kicks. The Korean has got a height advantage, a reach advantage, and she does look like she's going for the head. When Andreana did kick that 1 point, when she did score that 1 point, she was it was very fast compared to the movement of the either athlete had demonstrated before that. So she has got that speed, and if she can use that, who knows, maybe she could get some head kicks and get back into this match. So Andreana Aspogarakis, she's already in the ring, she's waiting for opponent. Just had some last minute coaching tips. Last round's underway now.
Green Catholic's definitely being more aggressive here.
Same weapon though, which has not got through for in the first two rounds.
Maybe she can try to switch back kick. Maybe she can pick up 3 points underneath. When the Korean launches attacks, pick up a Kyungo.
Stumble there for Lim. Yeah, that might give Aspogarakis some confidence because it was off of one of her kicks. She really needs to step it up now. She's not going to get the points like that. The Korean's got too long a leg. She's can't parrying the kicks away. She's not too concerned about not getting through. In fact, the Korean's moving forward now, tries the punch. Very close range, so not really long enough to register. So lots of little impacts on the body armors that are not strong enough to score. Lim's work rate slowing down, so she's now just working on the counter.
Yeah, she doesn't need to put herself in the danger zone as such. She seems pretty confident with Andreana's ability on the attack. She knows where she is.
Just checking the scoreboard there. Just a look there. She goes up for the head. We saw Wang from Taipei, who's got a strong lead against Ananovich, carried on attacking, carried on moving forwards. Different game style here. Maybe for the final. Asperger Akin needs to step it up, and she hasn't really got any answer to this Korean athlete. Another kick into the body, but it's too little too late. Last few seconds now.
She tried to reverse there. I think she should have been doing that a little bit from probably 30, 45 seconds.
It's too late, and that's the end of the match. Lim Gyeongbuil from Korea has claimed her place in the second semi-final of the minus 53 kilogram division. So we will see Yunwen Wang from Chinese Taipei versus Gyeongbuil Lim from Korea in the first final of today's session of the World Championships here in Chelyabinsk, Russia. So she looked very nervous going out. She's now discussing the techniques with the coach. She looks a little bit more relieved, looks more comfortable. She's got a tough final ahead of her, but she's there now. She's in the final of the World Championships. Not a bad place to be for such a young athlete. We're going to get quite a contrasting style now, hopefully, as we see the female heavyweight, the plus 73 kilogram division, about to get underway. Athletes are in the holding area, and the international referees are taking the place on the court. They can see in the video replay some of the action, some of the techniques, and that was the last bit where they stumbled. So, great match. Adriana Asperger-Aker will settle for bronze medal in this instance. Lim Gyeongbuil from South Korea claiming her place in the final. The next match coming up, plus 73, Nafi Akos from Turkey in blue, Bianca Wogden from Great Britain in red. Bianca Wogden is the 2014 European champion. She took bronze in the Grand Prix. And coming back from injury herself this year, she took the gold at the Spanish Open. But she has, she did experience quite a bad knee injury last year. That was in the Chinese, was that in the Suzhou Grand Prix, Luke?
Yeah, it was in the semi-finals against the Chinese athlete. They had a clash of legs. Bianca fell back on her knee, and unfortunately, that put her out for the rest of the year. She had a successful comeback though at the start of the year.
There we can see Nafi Akos from Turkey, the 20-year-old. She's had extensive training with Alitan, of the national Turkish coach. She's a world student champion from last year. The year before, she won the under-21 European Championships. Impressive start this year in the G-Class event. She won the Dutch Open and the Moldovan Open. So, really one to watch out for. She'll be quite confident. They had a very close match. The last time that they fought was in the Turkish Open. And there's only 1 point difference between them, with Nafi Akos taking the gold by 4 points to 3 against Bianca. But that was then, this is now, this is the World Championships. The first semi-final of the plus 73 kilogram division. Nafi Akos from Turkey in red, Bianca Wogden from Great Britain in blue. Athletes enter the rear end. You can see the matches that Curtis has had earlier on today. Beg your pardon, yesterday, to qualify for the final today. Bianca Wogden also took the European Championships in 2014. Thank you. Olympic referee Julie Dibb from Libya. Very experienced referee. Be controlling this match. If you're watching the competition for the first few days, we saw a lot of kicks close in. We've been calling PSS kicks. Some people call them a little bit different, chicken kicks or monkey kicks, but the technical delegate had words with the coaches and was cautioning them about that. So we've seen less of them in the last couple of days, which has been better for the sport. Strong start by both athletes. Morgan means business, coming fast off the front leg. Cuz not phases yet. Warden tries a back kick attack. Cuz counters, she takes the first point. It's good to see this sort of movement in the female heavyweight category. Actually moving quite a bit faster than what we saw in the lighter category. In close there, trying to steal a point. Waller's not having any of it. Just calm down a little bit now. Strong kick to the body. Turkish athlete goes high. Bianca goes high.
It's a nice start for Bianca. Very aggressive first minute. Taking a 3-1 lead. That's going to boost her confidence. Landing the first headshot.
But Nafi, of course, is getting some strong counter kicks in there. So she hasn't seen two phases yet, but like you say, a good start for Bianca Walden from Great Britain.
Attempted the back kick there. Just missing out on the threshold.
That's good to see an energetic start in this category.
It's definitely a more positive start from Bianca after what we've seen yesterday in the preliminaries. Just felt she was very edgy.
Just added a point there, walked in.
But this is definitely a more positive attitude.
It's very strong, very aggressive style that she's got, kicking to the body. So far she looks the stronger of the two athletes. But Koska's high with an axe kick. She's just out of range, but now she's pushing, pressurising. Bianca Walden, who tries her own axe kick. Nafia stumbles a little bit. She's going to get a Kyungo at the end of the round. So 4-1 to Bianca Walden of Great Britain against Nafia Kuz of Turkey. Good start for the Brit.
Yeah, very good start for Bianca. But just keep pushing, stay alert, not be too open on her own attacks. Her first attack was quite a wild back kick reverse, and Nafia pounced on that. The Turkish athlete did have some very hard, intense fights yesterday, coming from behind in both. So we know she can come from behind, and the coaching staff of GB will know that, so they'll be keeping Bianca on point.
Yeah, she has to stay focused, because there was a good head kick by the Turkish athletes which was just out of range. If she does connect with that, that deficit won't last very long. But Bianca Walden does look strong. She means business. She's trying to stop the Turkish plan to add to their gold and silver medals that they've got in previous day's competition. Referee there just telling to cover the arm guards up. The second round's underway, 4-1 to Great Britain. Walden goes high again. Good strong kick to the body there by Nafia Kuz. Didn't score, a good cover by Bianca Walden. Kuz's hair's caught into her the chin strap of her head guard. That might be a little bit distracting for her as the hair bounces against her neck. Walden a little bit more cautious now. Turkish athlete starting to take it forwards more. Bianca's putting a lot of weight on that back leg as she's leaning away, trying to keep out of range. of the Turkish athlete's front leg kicking. Needs to be maybe a little bit more mobile. Kuz adopts a position, she changes and moves around looking for the openings. Walton seems happy to work on the counters.
Yeah, she's just slowing down the game. The first round is quite aggressive for a female heavyweight matchup. She hasn't really took the same chances as she did in the first round, just trying to protect that 3-point lead.
She didn't really counter there very much, and we saw a PSS kick there by Kuz, didn't score. But there was quite a relaxed attacking combination by Kuz just there, which Bianca didn't pick up on. So Nafia Kuz from Turkey still taking the action forwards, trying to get back that difference, goes for a headshot.
Turkish athlete just seems to be struggling with the distance every time she comes. Bianca's just taking a little short step back, just out of range, and trying to pick up on the counter or shut her down.
Well, Nafia Kuz is definitely more aggressive in that round, but didn't get the points. So Bianca Walkden from Great Britain is leading 4-1 as we go into the third and final round. Assuming there's no end of this, and then there'll be a golden point, which is a fourth round in which the first point wins. Coach there stressing that she needs to be moving forwards, attacking more, trying to get through Walton's defences. Great Britain coach Paul Green trying to stay focused, stay concentrate, protect that lead. So we're in the third round now of the first semi-final of the heavyweight category for females, plus 73. At the World Taekwondo Championships here in the Traktor Arena in Chelyabinsk, Russia.
Well, one thing we know is Turkey's definitely going to come in. She won't leave it to the last 30 seconds. Bianca's just got to keep her wits about her, stay concentrated.
Just seem more proactive in this round than she was in the second round. Crystal, calm and confident.
Pressing forward.
Goes for a kicking combination again. Walks it towards anyone, goes off the headshot.
Two, double impact.
That's interesting, we've not seen that so far in the championships, and it's happened twice now for us this evening in the semi-finals.
That could have just secured Bianca, although Kuz has got some good back kicks if she can make him land.
And she's got just over a minute to do that. Last time when these two competed, the score was 4-3, so already there's a considerable difference. Walkden now controlling that centre ground. Nafia Kuz from Turkey needs to do something. The clock's counting down into the last minute.
45 seconds now, 9 points.
Bianca does seem to be breathing heavy, was working off that front leg.
I think the Turkish athlete is a bit mentally broken from that double impact. It sort of killed off most of her chance.
Strong punch there by Bianca Walkden from Great Britain. So nothing could put up now, but she seems resigned.
She seems disinterested.
Walkden hasn't. She's gone up for the headshot. Nafia Kuz really not doing enough work to get back into this match. The little half-hearted attempts there at the back kick.
She seems tired as well.
It's no good play for Kyongos. It looks like she's trying to edge Bianca Walden. No, she's so frustrated. She shakes her head there. Tries the PS. May get penalised for that. No.
2 seconds, she won't throw another technique.
That's it. Well, frustration got the better of Nafia Kuz there from Turkey. Towards the end of that second round, really after that two double impact head kick, she gave in there. She raises Bianca Walden's hand. She settled for the bronze medal. Settled a little bit early for it in some people's books. I'm not sure a coach seems okay with that. He might have words about that when they do a review afterwards.
I think that double impact headshot,
psychologically,
took the,
it really
took the sting,
did. Yeah.
And that was it. I think Nafia resigned herself. She was going to get bronze. It was a nice positive attitude there from Bianca. And she needs to push forward now. She's in the final. Just one match from being a world champion.
Well, the other final, we've got Gladys Sepang from France and Olga Ivanova, the local girl from Chelyabinsk, Russia. And the last time Bianca walked in and Ivanova competed, Bianca came off the better of the two, so Bianca will be quite happy about this.
I think personally, Bianca will prefer Ivanova to come through, even though she is the defending world champion.
Well, what can you say about Gladys Sepang from France? She's 31 years old. She was a world champion in 2009, 2011. She took a bronze medal at Beijing. 3 times European champion. She didn't make it to London 2012. Unfortunately, she was injured and had to withdraw. Olympic titles is just about the only thing that she hasn't had. She has had an incredible career competing in her first European championships in the 55 kilogram division. So an amazing life in Taekwondo and somebody that presents a real challenge. Well, let's see if Olga Ivanova is up to that. She's a current world champion and she took a bronze at the 2011 world championships as well, so she's got a great pedigree and a tremendous support from this local crowd. Russia's not taking a gold medal at this championships as yet, and they'll be supporting Ivanova, and she'll be their hope today in the female categories. As a local girl, they'll really want her to do it here. But she, first of all, has got the challenge of facing a very confident, almost as if she can hear it, she's nodding to us there, Gladys Sepang from France. She's focused, she's determined, and she's been here so many times before. Like we said, twice world champion, Olympic bronze medalist, 3 times European champion. Smiling, looking confident. Both athletes smiling, and Ivanova. Bit of a big deep breath there. The pressure's on, but 10 years age difference between them. Sepang from France, 31 years old. Ivanova from Chelyabinsk, Russia, 21. Two great athletes. The winner of this match will make it to the final of the female heavyweight category, the plus 73s, and will face Bianca Wogden from Great Britain. Introductions are made and the referees are in position, so just waiting for the athletes to come out now. Not fazed at all by the home supports for Ivanova.
She's a very experienced competitor. She's been in many situations where she would have been against very partisan crowds, home crowds of her opponent. She's very happy to be here. There was talk that maybe her not making London, having to withdraw through the entry, she might have to never fight again.
Well, she proved it all wrong with that. With that was the thought of the time. She had a back injury. It was quite, we thought, serious. It would lead to her retirement. But she's had none of it. The self-belief, absolutely incredible. And she's come back. And here she is in the final of the World Championships. With Rio next year, Rio Olympic Games. She's got her eyes on that as well, so no thoughts of retirement at this time. Just that gold Olympic medal that's eluded her. She's taken bronze in Beijing. Like we say, she couldn't compete in London because of that injury. So she might see this as a considerable stepping stone towards Rio. But But before she can get there, she's got to defeat Olga Ivanova from Chelyabinsk, Russia, the current world champion. Herself, oh, at 21, the world champion and a world bronze medalist even before that. So some incredible achievements for a young athlete. And the winner of this match will face Bianca Wogden from Great Britain. Just testing the protective scoring systems there. Everything seems fine. Tavares there from the referee. Olympic referee in London 2012. Let's see how this match goes. Cautious start, Luke, do you think? Or Ivanova seems to be moving King quite comfortably and confidently.
Yeah, I think Ivanova is going to want to keep the crowd behind her, or they will be behind her all the way, but keeping up the aggressive. Obviously, Gladys is a very physical, very strong fighter.
She's got to tag. Ivanova there goes high. No impacts and no points, but a sign of things to come possibly. Then a good clear kick to the body, not strong enough to register. French athlete less mobile, but seeming much stronger. Even overtakes the first point.
Nice first point there from Olga.
The Russian seems is a lighter athlete, more mobile. Closing her French opponent down there. Gladys won't be too concerned about 1 point at this stage. Nice counter kick from Olga there. Just destabilised her opponent a little bit, but she's calming down. She's gesturing with her hands, claiming the space. First minute down, 1-0 to Olga Ivanova from Chelyabinsk, Russia. She'll be desperate to win this match and the following one in front of this home crowd. Tremendous back kick there. You wouldn't want to be on the receiving end of that. Just even though we just slipped it, so it wasn't a clean impact, but a sign of things to come from for the Frenchwoman. Ivanova, lighter athlete, more mobile, but strong kick in there by Ipang to score the point to equalise it. Coming towards the end of the first round.
Good first round that.
All even, 1 point apiece. Seems quite relaxed there. Gladys Ipang from France. Seems comfortable, two very contrasting styles. Olga Ivanova, much more mobile. Very active, proactive. Gladys Ipang picking her techniques, but looking very, very strong when she does kick.
Gladys, a very strong, old school fighter. She's been around since, well, she picked up, she was in Athens, Olympics, in the under 57 kilo category. Worked her way up through the weights.
That's way back in 2004.
When her coach is picking up a silver medal. Yeah, teammates there praying for her. That was Abby Nier, minus 67.
The second round underway now. Russian goes high. First kicks the body, doesn't quite get the range right.
A strong back leg from Gladys, not quite registering, just clipping the Hogu, the body protector.
Referee's encouraging action, there's a strong kick that scored a point there. And for the first time in this match, the French woman is ahead. Even the moves in, tried to get the counter back. But got a bang from France down. Now she's definitely more aggressive, even though it goes high. Well covered. Quick check of the scoreboard, see if that point had registered. It hadn't. She still has a 1-point lead. Whoa, a powerful back kick by Pang. We should have felt that even over. The points that are on the board and they're starting to add up for the French woman. Ivanova needs to get some points back, but she'll have felt that back kick for sure.
Gladys is probably the strongest kicker in the heavyweight division. A very intimidating figure. Strong back legs, back kicks. Not shy of the 180s and reverses as well.
She gets a warning there for holding. Ivanova would be grateful for that because that back kick will have caught that. You know, these kicks do hurt. And they'll give her just a few seconds to compose herself. The lead of the French woman by Zapang. Oh, and a headshot there by Ivanova. Didn't register. Not sufficiently powerful. It did go up. It would have touched the head guard, but it wasn't an inward travelling action. It went straight up and fell to the side of the head guard, so it wouldn't score. But it's a sign of good things to come. If Ivanova can do that again, she will close this deficit down. We've got Zapang looking very, very strong and goes in for a strong kick to the body. For the last kick of the second round, strong kick to the body, which gives her a 6-point lead going into the third round. Ivanova's done some good headshots, but hasn't registered.
A very strong round there for Gladys. Three strong back leg body points. And that powerful back kick put Olga Ivanova three or four steps backward.
Well, the current world champion needs to step her game up now. We've used the word strong quite a lot to describe the French woman's techniques. Ivanova can't afford to get hit again. She needs to be moving out of the way, using a greater mobility. That's that back kick that you saw. Such incredible speed there by the French woman. Really have felt that, Ivanova.
Olga needs to get this crowd behind her, push her through this 2 minutes. It's her own city. Just needs to be a bit more agile when the French athlete pounces, tries her own touch. She's a bit too static.
Well, all the way through this match, Ivanova has been more mobile and she's looking for the techniques. Two headshots would equalise this match, bring it to level scores, but you'd be so cautious moving in against the French woman, afraid of those counter kicks. Another warning there. Another warning. So 5 points difference, another warning against the French woman. We close down to four, which is only a headshot. And a body kick. So Ivanova back in this game. The French woman moving back a little bit more now seems to be
another point off the back leg for Gladys. Olga's pad just seems to be too open for those back leg kicks. She's not covering well enough.
Well, it's good to see, and a strong punch there. Didn't register with the judges, but it was a strong punch. These techniques hurt. Ivanova looks quite distressed now. She's tired and she's up in this match against an incredibly strong athlete. Referee just trying to adjust the head guard there so the protection's in place properly. Another back kick by Ipang.
But it was Olga that scored. Tagged Ipang around the back.
And goes up the headshot.
None doing on the scoreboard again.
The Russian coach will be frustrated at that.
That's two attempts of a headshot now, just not registered on these electronic head guards.
She's moving in, change of technique, she's going through nice combination kicks there, but the clock's kicking down, she needs to be getting some points. The bank from France closing down, Grace Ivanova gets a warning. Referee just getting some direction there, the corner just, Collins has spent the match, but she hasn't seen it, she has now.
That's because the Kyungo didn't make it onto the board until just now. But now she'll be okay.
She'll just check to make sure that the referee. Yep, she's happy. A few words of advice from the Russian coach. Match is underway. Last 10 seconds. Can Ivanova bring it back?
5 seconds.
Goes up for the headshot. Another warning. It's not going to make much difference now.
5 to 8.
Olga Ivanova from Chelyabinsk, Russia, will have to settle for the bronze medal as she did in 2011. Bryce Pang, incredibly strong performance. Looks tired now, but incredibly strong performance. Coming back after injury and defeating the Russian athlete who's 10 years younger. She's there, she's in the final against Bianca Wogden of Great Britain. So the plus 73 athletes, Bianca Wogden from Great Britain in blue, and Gwalice Epang from France in red. Before we see that, we'll have the male minus 54 kilogram division semi-finals. Gwalice Epang from France, she'll be over the moon with that. She's confident. Discussion of performance, we can see some highlights now. Such strong kicks to the body.
She'll be very happy. She has a big rivalry with Bianca as well. They fought each other many times, so know each other's inside, their game inside out.
If you just looked at that back kick there, watch the way the Russian reacts. All the body's in shock there and really staggers backwards. What an incredibly powerful kick. I wouldn't want to get hit with that, that's for sure.
Certainly in training, when I'm taking back kicks, it sends me 4 or 5 meters back. It's a very powerful wind-taking kick. It's a heavyweight female, if you can imagine a plus 87 kilo male fighter kicking you with a back kick. It was like being kicked by a horse.
Right, we're getting ready now for the male minus 54 kilogram division semi-final. Teixeira Benelton from Brazil versus Stanislav Denisov from Russia. Denisov will be desperate to get to this final and to get the gold medal for Russia. That they're so, has proven so elusive in this championship for them.
Getting very frustrated in these semi-finals. All the Russian athletes have been very strong to get through to the medal matches, but they're just getting more and more frustrated in these semi-finals. We've seen on the first day, Ruslan Poiseev agonizingly close to reaching the final. Again with Albert Gorn suffering another golden point defeat. And last night's final, Alexei made it through to that final, but then suffered at the hands of Servet Tazagul. I actually learned today that yesterday's final actually landed on Servet Tazagul's mother's death anniversary. So he was very emotional that day.
There's lots of motivation for athletes, and Tazagul dedicated the gold medal from Olympic Games to his mother. Here we see the Brazilian Benelton Teixeira, who was actually raised by his grandmother. He's one of 15 grandchildren, so he knows hardship and he knows struggle.
He was very impressive yesterday in the preliminaries.
18 years old, winner of the US Open this year.
In red.
Incredible to be here at this age. And then again, Stanislav is only 21 years himself. He's represented Russia in the Grand Prix series. His medal at the under-21s, took the bronze medal at the this year, took a bronze medal at the Luxor Open. Today is carrying the hopes of this Russian crowd. The hopes for them to get into the medal and to get into the final. To get gold or preferably gold. Brazil looks incredibly focused. Years of age. the lighter weights do tend to be younger, so the careers tend to be shorter as the frame gets heavier. So we've got an 18-year-old and a 21-year-old here. Jan Zhang Wu from China, the referee in this match. There's quite a few finals and high-pressure matches at this championships, and done very well. So not quite the results that the some of the more prolific finalists, semi-finalists have achieved, but they're here. They're in the semi-finals of the World Championships. The minus 54 kilogram division, the action is about to get underway. Brazil in blue, Russia in red. Goes high. Still playing off the lead leg, as we'd expect, goes in for the punch.
And the Brazilian, very flexible athlete. He can change direction with his lead leg.
Strong kick there from the Russian to the body, doesn't register. Then Brazil goes high for the counter. Crediting over the top, but doesn't impact sufficiently to score. Goes high again. Good punch there by Denisov. Well covered by the Brazilian. Very, very fast kicking action by both these two athletes.
Strong punch there by Denisov, makes it onto the scoreboard.
Teixeira did try a credit kick over the top for the counter, but didn't impact. Definitely seems to be going for the head this time. There was an impact. He believes there's an impact there. Celebrated it, but not going to take the gamble at this stage of playing the video replay. Nice spinning kick by Denisov.
Not quite registering enough, not clean enough contact.
Again, headshots by the Brazilian. To these guys, there is only one medal, and it's gold. They're after the gold medal. To do that, they have to get through this semi-final, this first semi-final. Again, a headshot by the Brazilian, and again. First one, that's it, both have registered now.
That's really quieting up this Russian crowd.
They won't be happy at all. They've just seen their first athlete go out after headshots, and it's happening again. Deja vu for the crowd here in Russia. They don't want to set on again. Headshot by Denisov, who's covered well by the Brazilian.
It's a nice back hit there. He's getting back into this match. 6-4 now. That was a nice back kick to just before going into the break.
It was good, very good for the Russian there, because if he hadn't got that, such a gap, although it is only a couple, could only be a couple of kicks, such a gap is emotionally and psychologically weakening, and it's that mountain you've got to come back at. But he brought it back. Look at the focus on that young man there. Benetton Teixeira from Brazil is here. He means business. Look at that kick there, over the top, extended, and again, that's the 6 points. Drops it down, comes round, knocks the head guard one way. That's a double kick at the end, only one of the points scored. So he knocked the head guard one way, then had the courtesy of putting it back the other way. But Denisov, not intimidated himself, brought it back at the end there of that second round, so only 2 point difference. Can this crowd get behind him and get raise Denisov's performance so he can get it back? Brazilian does look incredibly dangerous when he extends up to those high shots. Little point added on there, he went high and then dropped it down to the body.
And the lead leg fighters use sort of the first motion of the lead leg just to deceive their opponent, move their arms, and then they'll just glide it into the body. Normally this, it's the second or the third direction of the kick.
Oh, incredible back kick there.
And he's scored that one.
And he's equalised. He's back in this game. It's off from Russia. The Brazilians seem to be taking it a little bit easier. Seem to go into cruise mode, maybe through his inexperience and youth. But Denisov brings it back. Can Denisov prove to be a stronger athlete here?
It's a nice strong punch. And they took it, so he's now on the lead.
For the first time in this match, Richard's leading. And 1 point is not that much of a lead, but he'll be happy with it. Great recovery by the Russian athlete in front of his home crowd. Oh, incredible headshot. Referee gives a standing count.
That's a nice, fast, straight up to the face of Teixeira. He seemed to be in cruise control and he was 6-1 up. Just took his foot off the gas. But we know from yesterday he has some very high scoring matches.
Well, Denisov punished him for this lack of concentration. So he's got to bring it back now. It's the Brazilian who's got to come from behind.
We know he's capable.
That was a good impact. Oh, goes high in the counter back kick.
But now he's got tagged over the top from the Teixeira's chop. It's 10-11. And Russia's picked up a Chongo for falling down.
The second round has really stepped up the level of competition here. The Brazilian's still going high. End of the round. A warning there for Sir Clayton going out of bounds. That's strange because he was chasing the Russian out. Counter back kick there to the body. No points. Wow. What a great second round that was in this semi-final, the minus 54 kilogram division. All change. Denisov ahead now just by the 1 point. Teixeira just seemed to take his foot off the gas, started cruising. And was punished for it. The Russian crowd happy again, hoping that their boy can come back and take this last round and get into the final. What a kick, whipped into the Brazilian's face. Hit, then he moved his head back. Nice extension through, referee comes in and gives a count.
Teixeira just got caught watching, he thought he was going to go into the body. He's seen his arms move to block towards the body. And Denisov punished him straight up to the face. 3 points. Thank you.
I think we're going to see some points in this round. Teixeira is not going to lie down now. He's serious. He means business.
Teixeira scored most of his points yesterday, actually, in those second and third rounds. Mainly the third.
Well, the referees, the judge at the back is saying wait. Oh, he wants the bell to be tight. He could have left that to the referee, really, but here we go. Third round underway. Comes in. The Russian gets a point as his Brazilian attacks.
The Chongo for Brazil for grabbing. Opens up a 3 point gap.
Strong punch,
Brazil.
Strong punch in the headshot.
No score. Still 3 points. Four now. As Russia cut underneath that attempted chop, but he gets grabbing as well.
3 points of difference. Headshot by the Brazilian.
Both went in for the punch.
Denisov there trying to tie him up in the clinch. Saw the scoring there, he's got a 3 point lead, he's holding on, two kicks into the body, moves in and clinches again. Got to be careful because he will get warned for this. Peloton tries a strong punch again, a little bit wild. Yeah. Teixeira slips down, he's going to get a Chongo. Could be crucial later on in this round. Berchtoff moves in with the punch, he celebrates, trying to influence the judges to score it, but they're having none of it. Could hear that one to the body. Oh, Little warning against Russia.
Minute to go now, 3 points in it.
Low kick there by Denisov, but it went unnoticed. He's turning, he's trying to hold, he will hold those clinches, and he'd be careful, he will get warned for it. Hilton needs to go high, needs to get those points. Nugent tried there on the movement out, but he fell over.
Opens up the gap to four. The Sortic Sierra is going to start chasing down some chops now. Maybe punish on the clinch with a crescent kick. Try the jumping chop.
Atmosphere in the hole now is electric. They're willing their boy on there here.
Can Denisov hold on for this 30 seconds?
A headshot there by the Brazilian Teixeira and a counter reverse. And he scores. He'll get the Congo, but he'll be happy with that. A reverse turning kick to the head. Tremendous technique. At this stage of the match, to throw that in when you're leading, this is what we want. This is Taekwondo.
7 point lead, 20 seconds.
He just checks the score there. He's getting frustrated. We've seen this before. The Brazilian player now moving forward, getting picked off on the way in. Congo for Denisov for going to the floor. He won't be too concerned about that.
If he does it one more time, he could be punishable for a gam junk. Three in a row. They're not fighting. He's on the floor, and Brazil splits up a headshot there.
He's clinching, he's closing. Needs to be careful. The Brazilian incredibly gymnastic there, the way he brought that foot up.
He's up. The Russian is now on 8 warnings. It's a 3 point gap. Brazil is going to play for a face kick, as well as maybe get some instructions into Teixeira. Almost like a basketball timeout, as we were saying yesterday.
Now, we've seen this before in the first air competition where the coach is playing for time to change the tactics, but he's claiming a headshot. And I think it's the kick that I was describing when they were very close in, where I described it as being gymnastic, and it was close, it went up there. It did look close. I didn't think it was a scoring technique. The coach will be using this opportunity. There you go, you can see the coach is giving the opportunity to give the explanation. This is what you need to do, he's saying. This is what you need to do to get back into this match in these closing seconds. So maybe those words of advice were worth playing the video replay card. This is the first semi-final of the minus 54 kilogram division. We've got a few seconds remaining. 4 seconds are on the clock. And this is the kick, this is where it came in.
It's clearly grabbing. There's no face kick.
There's no face kick, but like we said, was the coach using it to give advice? So the crowd are quite confident that there was no points there. We tend to agree with them here. It's unlikely it's going to score, but the coach did give him advice, so maybe that was more of what they're in for. Yes, it's been rejected.
4 seconds. Denisov must not run away because he will be punished by a gambler. He has to fight for these final 4 seconds.
The referee just pausing there while the screen's cleared. And they're calling in for a right to reset the system, which will give the Brazilian coach more time for feedback. We've got 4 seconds. We want this match to get underway as quickly as possible. Denisov will feel it more than anybody. He knows he can't back off or he risks being penalised. Here we go. Teixeira goes forwards. He's kicking, he's moving forwards. He goes to the back kick. He's going to get
Wang Kyongo. And he's lucky there's no time left on the clock.
That's it. Stanislav Denisov claims the place in the final. What an incredible match. High scoring match. Teixeira from Brazil looked very, very strong. Very, very focused. Very, very confident in the first round. Went into cruise control in the second round, was punished by the Russian for that. Couldn't get back into the round, it's very, very close. But Denisov takes the first place into the into the final of the World Championships. Great scoring, great techniques, this is what we want to see. I'll be happy if the second semi-final lives up to that, which we really expect it will do.
That was a great semi-final. And the Russians will be happy, just like yesterday, with Alexei Denisenko making the final. They have another Russian athlete to cheer on, Stanislav Denisov, stepping into the shoes of the great Russian 54, Saifullah Magomedov.
And some incredible kicks thrown in that match. It's great. That's what we want to see in the 54 kilogram division. They're light, they're fast, they're agile. See these points. So we have Thailand in blue, Ramnarong Sawik Wihari, the 2014 bronze medalist at the Asian Games, and he is against legend, that is Kim Tae-hoon, 21 year old. 2013 is the world champion, 2014 Asian champion. He took gold at the Grand Prix in Suzhou in China, and bronze at the final in Querétaro, Mexico. Saw that as a little bit of a blip, but Kim Tae-hoon, definitely favorite on paper to win this. He's got a reach advantage and a height advantage, you can see over Ramnarong there.
That's a big difference there. That's probably a good 5 or 6 inches.
But he doesn't seem too fazed by it. He's looking quite relaxed.
And he should be. He dumped out world number one, Tortosa. Oh. My mistake, I don't think he is world number one, Tortosa. Looking at the wrong draw sheet. But the Spanish athlete is a very himself, so he isn't going to be put off by the height. He's got a very nice style. He had a very exciting quarterfinal against Japan yesterday. But he's against the defending champion, that is Kim.
Well, for the crowd and for the spectators at home, let's hope that this match lives up to the first semi-final. That's an incredible match, Brazil and Russia. Whoever gets through will not only be facing Stanislav Denisov of Russia, but this crowd as well. And the hopes of the Russian country that's watching this, desperate for Denisov to be their first world champion. Well, the scene is set. The international referees are in place. I think we're about to see the introductions made. Harry Ramnarong from Thailand in red, Kim Tae-hoon from Korea in blue. Incredible results for Kim Tae-hoon, 21 years of age, world champion, Asian Games champion. Great success in the Grand Prix series. Has a very young team. So far it's working well for them. It looks very, very promising for Korea, for Rio 2016. I'm sure that concerns a lot of other nations. Sawik Wihari Ramnarong from Thailand won't have read that script, and he's here to take his place in the final, and he wants to be up against Denisov of Russia. But first, he must defeat Kim Tae-hoon. The big ask. High scoring matches there as he's qualified yesterday. Tae-hoon took the gold in Suzhou, China in the Grand Prix. She got bronze in December, the finals. Some great matches to get here. Maria Mercouri, referee from Georgia, originally from Greece. A very strong candidate for being one of the referees in Rio. Bearing in mind that the referees are undergoing a selection process, and they'll be hoping that they give a good show and get selected to be a referee at the Olympic Games. They go under the title of ITOs, International Technical Officials. They put years of efforts in, don't forget what the referees have to do to get to this level. There she goes, just adjusting the chin strap and run away. Fast counter back kick by the Thai athlete. Fast movements and changes of stances. Lead off the front leg by Thailand. And again, goes for the rabbit kick unsuccessfully. Low kick there. On the counter, but it's not too much concern for the Korean. Kim goes for his own counter. Rapid back kick there. The Thai athlete celebrated, but it didn't score. China thinks to come, we hope. No points as yet. Some rapid action.
But this Thai athlete has a very beautiful style to watch.
Celebrated and gets scores. Scores that punch. I think the celebration did help there. Didn't really look like a clear impact, but happy that it was. So 1-0 to Thailand. Strong kick by Kim to the body. You won't be worried about the 1 point difference at this stage. Oh, a nice counter. Went up for the head. Thai athlete celebrating there, but prematurely, there's no score. Korea started to step it up, and he got kicking combinations going high himself. Second punch by Ramnarong Sawikari.
Another punch there.
We heard the impact there, but it didn't score. I'd say that was a stronger punch than the one that did score, but Kim not phased at all. Very, very fast speed off the Thai athlete. Front and back leg.
Good
defence, yeah. We saw that.
Using the ring well, moving around Kim's long legs.
Good start by the Thai athlete. Ramnarong. Ramnarong Sawikwahari from Thailand has a 1 point lead into the second round. You can see the punching attempts there. Like I said, the celebration might have influenced the judges. The referees are being assessed in the performance in these finals. And that last round, Luke, do you think it should have been a Gamjung at the end there for the Russian? And that last Kyungo that he got at the very end?
He was definitely evading quite a lot, but no, I think he did enough only to warrant the Kyungo. I think a Gamjung in that situation would have been very, very harsh.
Well, it gave us the right result anyway. Denisov did come back from behind. Tian Kim had been told to wipe the trunk protector. It's too wet. That might interfere with the scoring by the technique slipping off or not impacting clearly. Kim comes out much more aggressive in this second round. A fast counter back kick by Thai athlete.
Tries that to the face. having a disc glance in the shoulder.
And Tan Kim will be a little bit frustrated now that he hasn't scored yet. Sawi Kari.
He's got a very good judge of distance. He's a Thai athlete.
He's more than making up for his height disadvantage and reach disadvantage right now. But can he keep this work rate up through the end of the second round and the third round? Tan Kim always looks dangerous, looks capable of going up to the head. Tries then. Nice spinning kick. Tan Kim still to score. Too convincing an axe kick there. Kim throws a back kick. Another punch. And the scoring. The judges going for the 2 points in this match that have been scored so far. The punches scored by the judges. Nice attempt at a back kick, but really good cover by Kim.
Who takes his own point back.
Kim must be starting to feel a little bit frustrated. A little bit of a cache of legs there.
See the pain on Pereira's face.
He's not too happy right now. Nice high attempt there by Taeyong Kim.
Just falling short. He's just not judging this distance quite right. Thai athlete's just getting out of the way.
Kim Taeyong's going to be frustrated. It's a lot lower scoring match than the first semi-final. Thai athlete moving around fast, yeah, evading there. He'll get a warning for ducking down there. It's quite dangerous. If you duck down and the kick comes up, you can have a serious injury. So it's an automatic warning. Another warning could end up. Oh, and a headshot there by Kim.
I think we're seeing a pill here. And the judges have got, all three judges have their hands up. I just wonder if they give the 3 points, whether the Thailand coach will appeal and say no face kick.
I think there's a clear headshot there, do you not think, Luke?
I think there was definitely impact with the head, whether it was the face.
Well, the judges have gone for it. They've given it, they've awarded 3 points. So Taeyong Kim's in the lead now.
And the Thailand coach won't protest that. He'll save his card for another day.
I think that was the right call, to be honest. I thought that we'll probably see in the replay, hopefully. All of a sudden, it's brought Taeyong Kim back into this game. I do hope we get to see a replay on that kick. Again, incredibly fast motion. Ran the wrong. Sawi Kari has been moving around the ring using lots of speed. Here we go. That's first one into the body. There's the extension. Yeah, it's a clear impact. Put into the face. The head guard did move, it clipped the head guard on the way down, but it was a kick into the face, which is scored by the judges. The Thai athlete will be a bit frustrated about that after leading for so much of the first and second.
He still seems confident, he seems in control. And in discussions with his coach, still think Kim is still going to be a little bit frustrated, even though he is leading 4-2. He's found it very hard to hit his entire opponent.
It does look frustrated, but I've seen him look like this before in all of the Grand Prix matches. It's not anything different for him. I think he would like to have had more scores on the board by now. The Thai athlete desperate to get the points back. He's moving fast. Coming off the back leg, nice back kick counter there.
Didn't register.
Good cover by the Korean. Spinning combination there. Last kick went low. The Thai athlete using the spinning techniques to get in close. Goes underneath there for the back kick.
He's just got to be careful that Kim doesn't reach over, tries to get him.
Like, scored one there.
Yeah, it tags him underneath as he came in for the punch.
Goes up for a headshot himself and celebrates it. And one of the judges put their hand up there. It was on our blind side, so we couldn't see if there was an impact to the face.
Even if the judges don't put it on, the Thai coach is ready to protest. He's confident of a face kick.
It was to our blind side, but we did see the head move back, so it would suggest that there was an impact. And I think we can see clearly there that one of the judges shaking her head because it would be on her blind side, so she wouldn't have seen that. The Croatian judge wouldn't have had a clear view of that. Well, the Dutch judge on the corner, so the coach is appealing for a three-point headshot. Now, what will happen is the cameras are set this way, so they'll bring the third camera in, which is sided to the other side, if necessary. And we'll see if there was an impact. It did seem like it from the effect on the head, but we didn't get a clear image of it, clear view of it. And that's the camera from the other side, and that definitely seemed to touch. Now, bear in mind that the view that the judges get is slightly different to ours.
And they've given an X.
And they've rejected it. Well, that'll be disappointing for Ramnarong from Thailand.
Plenty of people in the crowd thought that one scored.
I think Kim can be a little bit lucky with that. That would have tied the score.
6-2 now.
The Korean picking his opponent off as he's moving in. Goes up for headshots, moving around the ring. Mosman managing to stay inside the octagon. Kim Tae-yeon looking for the points on the way in as his opponent's attacking him.
Tenth of a reverse there by Thailand. 15 seconds.
So where Harry's got to find a way in. It's looking incredibly difficult now at this stage of the game.
Last two.
It's not for lack of effort. That looked like an accidental fall there by the Korean.
It's the end of the match.
Bit of an anti-climax there for the Thai athlete who had been so active in that game. Very well deserved bronze medal for Ramnarong Sawigwahari. Some people might see Kim Tae-yeon has been a bit fortunate that headshot didn't score. He won't be unduly concerned by it. The current world champion now in the final to defend his title. And he will face Stanislav Denisov from Russia. So nice action, the three sets of semi-finals that we've seen today. Contrasting styles, but all good kicking techniques and movement, and brave effort there by the Thai athlete. Nice headshot. Made the difference, really. Nice extension and through. Kim Tae-yeon now needs to compose himself, prepare for his final. It does have time because there will be the two female matches first and the presentation of medals and awards, so it will be quite a while before they're back up, so he's got time to recover. See the female athletes in the holding area, so there shouldn't be too long a delay. The minus 53 kilogram division
of the evening, three finals to come altogether. This is the
we have Yun Wen Wang from Chinese Taipei in blue against Lim Gumbyol from Korea in red. Making way to the field of play. The referees are already taking their position. Taipei. Current Asian Games champion and World Student Champion. Against Lim Gyum-yo, the World Silver Medalist, and one of his group of his team of young Koreans. Which marks a impressive development plan by the Korean team. So Luke, anticipations, predictions?
I like the Chinese Taipei athlete. I think she's very strong in attack. I feel she's got more in her arsenal in terms of techniques than the Koreans have certainly shown anyways. I think we're going to see Chinese Taipei with their second gold medal. I'd be surprised if this Korean athlete can overcome the number one seed here.
Byol from Korea, she has got a height advantage, reach advantage, but on paper, on the form book, Chinese Taipei athlete will be the favourite. She'll compose herself before she makes her way into the ring. The Greek referee Antonia. Making sure the preparations are in order. We call the Korean athletes, waiting for it to come onto the contest area to do the PSS checks. Just checking the impact there, obviously not power, it's just the impact, the recording, making sure that it's registering. No problems. Making sure the gum shields are in. And we're underway. Nice mark of respect there. The handshake, acknowledgement to the coaches. So Wang from Chinese Taipei versus Lim from Korea. Lim in red, Wang in blue. Korean athlete with a height advantage. Going up for the head straight away. Taipei trying to cut underneath. Korean athlete does seem to change stance more, using both legs. That's something we do see in Taekwondo, probably more than other kicking arts, in that you do change your stance. You don't have your favourite side. Well, you have your favourite side, but you don't have, you know, there's more exchanges off the back leg and off alternate sides.
Yeah, you kind of try not to play into your opponent's favourite side. You don't want them to feel comfortable in the stance that they're in, a closed stance or an open stance, and depending on what leg they prefer, try and take that their preferred option away from them.
No points as yet. Halfway through the first round. Will it be particularly accurate as yet?
It's quite a sloppy opening. Few exchanges, no real impacts onto the body armors like we've seen in previous matches today.
Wang there goes in for the body off the front leg. Good defense by Taipei, something that we saw in the first semi-final. Good defense, good cover. It's going to be difficult for the Korean to get in there. So Korea red, Chinese Taipei in blue. No points in the first round.
Quite a meddling, messy first round. As we expected, both athletes looking just to close down the distance on their first and then bring it down either to the body or try a flick up to the high section. Looking to capitalize on their second or third technique.
That's the first round of the World Championship final. Lever wants to make him active, just not seen the nice scoring techniques we've seen in previous semi-final matches. they're cancelling each other out. Range is a little bit sloppy. Let's see if they can do a little bit different in the second round. Has been called again. Okay, just indicates to get onto the mat as quickly as you can. Going high there. Allen makes contact, but not scoring.
I see an appeal here.
Well, the judges have put their hands up, so that'll be considered first. What will happen is if one of the judges thinks there's a clear score, they will indicate it to the others. They'll confer. If it's not clear, if it is clear, they'll award the point. If not, if there's agreement, they'll award the point. If not, then the coach has the option to make a video replay appeal. But in that instance, the judges awarded 3 points. It did look like it was a good impact.
And Taipei will appeal. They believe it hit onto the side of the electronic helmet, not on the face.
That's right, the kick had to go to the face. That's all the judges can score, because the PSS head guard determines whether a kick is to the head or not. It's a little bit of one of those grey areas, because you can impact the face and the foot carry on to touch the head guard, but we'll see it in slow motion. See,
I think there was some face contact in there.
It did seem to be from that image. Let's have a look again, hopefully. And just remember, if you can just see in the top left hand corner there, that is what the judges are seeing. That is the imagery that the judges are seeing. I think he's going to lose his card, the Taipei coach. He is, it's rejected. That might cost him later on, let's hope not. He picks up another point. You get a Kyungo for falling over.
The career just picked up a point on the counter as Taipei's pressing out, leaving herself a little bit more open.
Got to be careful here, not to be too keen to get it back and get countered. Could be a Kyungo there.
Got her first point and she's pushed Korea out.
A bit careless of the Korean there to allow herself to be pushed out of the ring. And she's getting close to the edge again. You think she'd be moving more around her opponent. She's nearly there, she's going to get it. There'll be another Kyungo against Korea.
I just wonder if Taipei's first point was actually scored out of bounds. I'm not sure if you've seen anything there, Mike.
She was kicking as she was moving forward, so I'd give her the benefit of the doubt. But I just don't understand why the Korean athlete allowed herself to be taken out of the ring twice there. It just seemed really
She doesn't seem that lazy. Physically strong either, for me personally. The Taipei athlete is definitely the stronger of the two athletes, and even though she is smaller, she carries a strength well in her build.
There's a strong punch there that didn't score. I definitely think the Korean athlete would be more mobile at this time.
She's very close to that boundary again. This time, stopping, holding her ground.
That's more like it. Now you can see her moving around, but she is skirting around the edges, so she needs to be careful. She definitely doesn't seem to have the same strength that the Taipei athlete has, but she's literally holding on to that lead. Closing moments of the second round. Taipei will be feeling quite frustrated. She's a stronger athlete, she's the most proactive one. Currently 3 points behind, but that could be just one headshot. She goes to the back kick. I don't really know what to make of that, Luke. She's just, the Korean athlete just seemed to be ticking over there. I mean, we saw the Brazilian get severely punished in the men's semi-final for starting to cruise, but the Korean athlete there, Lim, just seemed to be in slow motion.
She seemed very lethargic, but I think that's the way she plays. That's her kind of a game. She's a very cancellation, messy type of fighter. She's really making it difficult for Taipei to make any sort of ground, to make her techniques count. She's just cancelling and making it very messy, but she's also draining the Chinese Taipei athlete. She's using so much energy on techniques and kicks that aren't really being rewarded on the scoreboard. And being cancelled out underneath by the Korean athlete.
Well, let's see if the Taipei athlete can score now. Yunmen Wang in blue, Lim Gumbiol in red. Korean definitely playing a spoiling game, but was got caught again towards the end, and the
very
Taipei pushing forwards again. That's it. It's a second.
But she's picked up a point, which will cancel out the
two Kyungos.
6-3, still a 3-point advantage.
Taipei goes high, but hasn't got the same reach, and the Korean kick high then. And she says, yes, I hit. She's indicating to a coach, making appeal.
First glance for me, I think that was the side of the helmet at first glance. The Taipei athlete looked to turn away. You'll see.
Well, the Korean was quite determined. She was very confident. She started indicating the coach straight away. Yep, very clearly there, claiming a face kick. Here's our video replay. Can't tell from that angle whether it's the face or the head. You can see the symboling though.
Sometimes athletes can get a bit carried away because they get unsighted when they're kicking. Sometimes they don't they can feel a contact on their foot, but sometimes they don't know what they can hit.
Now there, you can just see the left-hand side, the impact. Started high, looked like he was going to hit the head guard, that pulled back possibly to the face. The image is not clear enough from us from this side. That angle was just a bit late, I think that's just after the kick, so we'll leave this one to the judges to decide and not offer our expert opinions in this instance. It's Barbara Marion there from Canada. It's accepted. Denis Oju. With France, Barbara Marion from Canada. Two very senior, experienced video replay judges have said yes, that was a point. So Korea now leading by 9-3. Halfway through the second round, third round, final round.
She just
kept one foot inside of the ring, just took another point as well. Nice reverse attempt by Taipei. And again a back kick attempt by Wang. Less than a minute, she needs to get these points back.
Another attempt.
She's going for it.
Just not finding the right contact. Her arm guard's risen up towards her shoulder there, so she needs to correct that.
It would restrict her movement, obviously, and an ability to defend herself. She needs to do it quickly so that she isn't given a warning for delaying, and the referee gets involved there to speed up the process.
Last 45 seconds.
Wang really needs to get these spinning kicks or headshots in, and tries for one,
low back
goes
kick.
Low, and she's going to be penalised for that. Looking frustrated now. She can't get inside the long legs of the Korean, who goes up for a headshot. She's managed to stay inside the ring now. We've got an appeal by the Korean coach for a headshot. So, his athlete 7 points up. Less than 30 seconds. I think that was the chin of the head guard. Like I say, the always can remember that the video review judges have a different image than what we have. The three cameras in place around the ring. Taipei unlucky not to score to the body there, because she pulled back and impacted with the toes. She should have pushed her foot forward, she could have got a point. Green coach clapping there, just trying to influence the judges as he's studying the image. I think this will be rejected. I think it's too close to call. I think there might be points out there. That's hitting the head guard, looking for another camera angle. Looking for the third camera angle. There's two automatic camera imagery, and then there's a third that can be introduced if it's not clear. And this is a new system that's been used in the World Championships. And it's going to slow the end of this match down quite a bit. As we look for this third image. In the Olympic Games, we actually use five cameras. One from each side of the surrounding square of the contest area, and one overhead camera. World Championships is three cameras, two main cameras, and then a backup. And we're just waiting from the imagery from the backup camera to see actually comes. Takes some time for this to be processed. Live imagery coming from the first two cameras. The third one is a recording camera, so they're bringing a memory card. So it's taken a while, and this new system, which has been a little bit frustrating for some of the coaches, as the video replay, as a judge, you try to do the video review in under 1 minute, but we've already exceeded that now. So there's only 29 seconds on the clock, but we could be another minute or two before a decision's made on the video review.
Yeah, this review's taking a good 3 or 4 minutes already.
And they have to take the imagery back, so.
Also, this can have an effect on the two players as their bodies start to cool down. Their thought process, maybe their nerves start building.
The Taipei athlete looking to a coach for advice.
She'll be hoping that the 3 points won't be added and it remains a 7 point.
It's rejected. So we're underway. The 7 point stairs there, 7 point difference. Taipei comes in for a reverse kick. She knows she's got to get these big scoring points, big scoring kicks in.
Chasing the crane down.
She is kicking, but she's going to go out of the contest area again, so she will get the Kyungo.
It's five warnings now for Korea.
Big punch by Wang that scores. 6 points difference, two headshots, back kick, another Kyungo.
5 points difference, 5 seconds.
Korea's still working.
One second. I think Korea is a world champion.
That's it. Lim Gyeongbol from Korea, the 2014 World Junior Silver Medalist, goes one better at senior level, and she is world champion in the minus 53 kilogram female division. At the World Championships, she's today's first world champion here in Chelyabinsk. The actual video review there just took the impetus off at the end of the match there. But all credit to Lim from Korea, this young athlete, part of the Korean Development Program, has proven that it's working well, and she's taken the gold medal. Coach is delighted.
Yeah, what a feeling that must be. Champion. Such a young age. Korea to so many world champions over the years since the introduction of Taekwondo to the world.
Yep, the first world championships hosted in Seoul, Korea in 1973. The national sport of Korea, they can see the headshot to the face. Scored by the judges, not by the head guard PSS, protective scoring system. The medal awarding ceremony will take place. Ceremony, and then following that, the final of the 73 kilogram female division, the heavyweights. And that should start just over 10 minutes time, hopefully. There'll be the awarding ceremony, the medals and gifts. We'll see the national anthem, the flag raised, and the national anthem played of Korea again. And then straight away, hopefully, we'll see the final of the 73 kilogram division. So we're looking at that local time to be about 10 past 8 in the evening. It's now, 10 past 9. So that's just over 12 minutes away for the next match.
Ceremony about to take place for the female minus 53 kilograms.
Дамы и господа, мы начинаем церемонию награждения в женской весовой категории до 53 килограмма.
Presented by Mr. Anatoly Terekov, WTF Council Member.
Медали вручает Анатолий Терехов, член Совета Всемирной Федерации Тхэквондо.
And the athletes there just behind the podium waiting for the presentation.
From Greece, Adriana Aspro-Garaka. And from Croatia, Anna Zelinovic.
Bronze medal has been presented by the president of the Russian Taekwondo Union.
Anna Zelinovic.
Adriana Aspro-Garaka from Greece. And Anna Zelinovic from Croatia.
Silver medalist from Chinese Taipei.
Anna Zelinovic now has a full set, gold, silver and bronze at World Championships. silver medal to Yunwen Wang from Chinese Taipei. Brave, strong performance from her. She couldn't quite overcome the leg length,
the gold medalist,
and the awkward style of her Korean
WTF
opponent,
world champion,
who is now
Korea,
world champion for 2015. Lim Gyeongbyeol, a former world junior silver medalist, goes one better at senior level and is a new world champion.
Lim Gyeongbyeol,
world champion at the minus 53 kilogram division.
Taekwondo Championships here in Challenger 2015.
Цветы вручает Максим Алексеевич Карпов, директор чемпионата мира по тайквондо 2015.
You can see the mascots and the flowers being presented to bronze medalists. Initially, they'll be greatly disappointed they've not made it to the final and taken the gold. To many of these athletes, like we said earlier, there is only one medal and that is gold. But they will settle for that and take great pride in these achievements when they've had time to think about it. Flag and the national anthem of Korea.
Ladies and gentlemen, please congratulate our medalist and the new WTF World Champion from Korea.
That's our first World Champion gold medal of the evening awarded to Lim Gyeongbyeol of South Korea. Of awards. Lim Gyeongbyeol from Korea, gold. Yunwen Wang from Taipei, silver. Anna Zananovich and Andriana Asburgaraka, bronze medalists. Minus 53 kilogram division at the World Championships, organized by the World Taekwondo Federation and the Russian Taekwondo Federation here in Chelyabinsk, Russia. Thank you. So coming up, the final of the plus 73 kilogram heavyweight female division of the World Championships, featuring Bianca Wogden of Great Britain, the current European champion, against Gladys Epang from France, the veteran of the sport, 31 years of age, Olympic bronze medalist from Beijing back in 2008, three times European champion and world champion in 2009 and 2011. There we can see the mascots. I don't think Gladys or Bianca will be in disguise. Can we see them in the... Is that them taking position in the holding area? We've got quite a bird's eye view here.
I can see Bianca, I think it is. Just...
Yep.
Yeah, and there's
there
Gladys.
They are. There's Gladys. So they are ready to come on. We can see members of the French delegation moving forward.
Pascal Jonceau, great French champion. We'll see him there in the white suit, front row, watching on. Gladys, former teammate.
The birthday boy yesterday. A great champion and a great ambassador for Taekwondo. It's great to see him here supporting his former teammate. And there she is with her eyes closed and focusing. Deep breaths, focus and concentration as she prepares for this final match against fellow European Bianca Wogden from Great Britain. The current European champion against the former European champion, three times European champion. Bianca Wogden wanted to become world champion against the former two times world champion. This promises to be an amazing match.
Bianca looks very relaxed. Normally she's quite tense. She is very relaxed. Good to see.
In red, home. From France,
such a relief for the Great Britain contingent after she was injured in Suzhou last year in China for the Grand Prix. She made a full shed surgery, I believe, and then...
Yeah, she had a second ACL operation after that. It kind of got to be angry. She was such a great run of form, taking that European title last year in May. It looked coming right for her in major championships. And then that injury, but she's back. First major of the year. She's in the final, and she wants to take that gold medal.
And it's not just any final, it's the final of the World Taekwondo Championships. And she's against legendary Gladys Epang from France.
Rivalry, they fought each other countless times in open competitions. I think Gladys is ahead in the head-to-head rivalry. But this is a major final, and rivalries, and those statistics don't count. It's these 6 minutes, and who's going to have the most points on the scoreboard at the end, that's going to decide it.
In the semi-final, we saw Bianca being very strong, cutting into the body, very, very determined and very, very fast. Gladys depended on her strength, a weight and size advantage. They've scored some brilliant kicks, especially that back kick that we saw shake Olga Ivanova. It's going to be interesting. Two literal giants of Taekwondo in the ring there. We're checking the PSS. We want to be sure it's working properly. Referee there, Olympic referee, making sure the gum shields are in place. Bianca Wagner from Great Britain in blue. Guara Sepang from France in red. The final of the heavyweight plus 73 female weight division at the 2015 World Taekwondo Championships. As in the semi-final and the preliminary matches, Bianca moves forward attacking, Gladys closes down, not having any of it. We expected Bianca to be more mobile, and so far she has been.
Using that longer front leg as she has. She's trying to push Gladys away.
Tries a close range kick there. It was quite a kick rather than the PSS point, but it didn't register anyway. Good defense by the French athlete. Bianca goes high, drops in. That shouts for the punch, but it's not awarded. And a warning there for Bianca for holding. Bianca Wagden from Great Britain gets a warning for holding. Yeah. I think it's as much because she tried the PSS kick.
Yeah. She just keeps to a normal, simple game.
No points as yet after the first minute. Thinking a little bit more about placement to these techniques. Gladys still looking for the counter rather than leading them with the attack. Referee indicating both athletes to be more active.
Big shout there for Bianca on a punch. Not quite strong enough to convince the judges that it should be worthy of a point.
Good start for both athletes.
Yeah, both holding their ground quite well.
Right. Bianca leading in there, Gladys going for the counter, strong counter, but good defence by the British athlete. Bianca tries a long back kick, gets counter kick, but covers well, so no points scored by either of them in the first round.
Gladys just missing out on the required threshold to score. We've seen in the first semi-final, Bianca launched a long back kick type reverse and Nafia Kuss of Turkey capitalised on that one but failed in the rest of the match. That's why Bianca is in the final. She needs to keep things simple, not take too many risks. You see a big French team supporting Gladys. Unfortunately, some of the British athletes have already gone home.
A big weekend of competition coming up yet. We're in the way for the second round. No points scored yet. On as even at this stage. There was a Union flag in the background there, but here we go. Second round. The legend from France, Gladys Sepang in red. European champion, Bianca Wagden in blue from Great Britain. On is even at this stage. A little bit of an impact there with the knee, but accidental. Not too much concern by Bianca there. Still being the more aggressive, taking the match to a French opponent. Nice kick there from Gladys off the back leg.
Good cover good from cover. Bianca.
Just that one Kyungo difference between them at this stage. Big punch from this French woman again. Not accurate, doesn't score.
Just over halfway now in this match. No points on the scoreboard as yet. Just wondering if that Kyungo for Bianca is going to come involved.
Well, we've seen Bianca scoring good headshots. We've seen Gwalis score with these incredible back kicks, so it's unlikely it'll be 0-0 at the end. Tactical match so far, but strong. Both of them hitting really hard, but not strong enough to register at this time.
They both know each other's game so well. After all their countless battles, maybe it'll take something slightly different. The catch is a
nice headshot there. Nice attempt by Bianca Wogden from Great Britain.
Not quite registering or contacting with the head guard.
I don't think it contact. I think Gwalis just stepped back, just out of range. But a good attempt nonetheless. Great Britain 0, France 0. That's Max end of the second round. No points scored. Plenty of activity.
It's going to be a test of nerve now going into this final round. Tight level affair.
Bianca Wogden from Great Britain, the younger of the athlete. European champion, but she might feel more pressure to go first. Needs to be careful not to get caught on the counter. By that incredible back kick of Gladys Apang for France. She seems very calm. Listen careful to her coach.
Megan still looks very calm. She's reigning European champion. Gladys went out very early in that European Championships, as she did last World Championships. So she'll be happy to be in this World Final. Mr. Bianca looking to become a first-time World Champion. Gladys looking to make it a hat-trick.
It will be amazing for Bianca Wogden to take this title after that injury. It was a serious injury and, like you said, incredibly frustrating.
And it almost got to cement her rear ambitions.
But Gladys Apang in the way. She's got other ideas. Twice World Champion. Olympic bronze medalist in Beijing. The veteran of the sport. She's changed weight divisions. She's gone from 55 kilograms all the way up. She's gone through different competition styles, pre-PSS, pre-electronic head guards. She's been there, done it, and got the title to show
her. First point goes
to France. Takes the first point.
Solid point there by Gladys. No need to panic though for Bianca. Still plenty of time. She's got the big chop, the 3 points.
Gladys Apang definitely goes through there, goes up for the crescent to the head, but just falls short. Before that, Apang from France was spinning in. Great mobility.
I thought she might have got penalised for almost a rabbit type kick in action.
Wogden has got that Kyungo, so she does need to be careful.
45 seconds.
1 point the difference between them right now. Bianca moves in, takes a clash to the knee. Gladys strong and holding the ground.
30 seconds.
France on the counter again. Just look to the monitor, make sure. Shake nods ahead at her opponent. I'm here. Bianca goes high again.
Gladys going to penalise. She's going to go 2-0 behind now.
2-0 behind, and she's hurt her leg.
British coach is going to play the card.
Going to play the card for the headshot. Three points a headshot. Now, you cannot actually appeal against the PSS head guard if the point doesn't register, so
headshot or face shot?
Well, the referee's taking it as face shot because he's not rejected it, so he's saying face. Let's see what he says. We can hear. He did face definitely kick. Said face kick. Definitely said face kick. Let's see how that looks. I don't think there's impact. As she pulls it back here, she's pulling it back.
No, I don't think there's any doing there, but 20 seconds just to compose. She knows what she has to do.
She can focus. It's rejected very quickly this time, we're happy to say. So France with a 2-point lead over Great Britain. The veteran, Gladys Apang, now holding on, trying to hold on to the lead. She's going to get a warning. And the 3-point scored, but that's going to be taken off. The referee's trying to calm down because he had calling for Callio. He's taking the headshot off. Gives a Kyungo against France.
Oh, Gang, he got penalised. Kyungo again. Just
gives a Kyungo. It was an accidental action that started. If it had been a deliberate action to a fallen opponent, she'd have got the Gamjung. So,
and there it is! 3-2.
Again, Gladys will get a Kyungo.
Gladys' first Kyungo hasn't gone on the board, I don't believe. It should be 4-2 to Britain, if I'm correct.
There's 5 seconds left. Can Vice Brang bring it back at this stage?
And Bianca's done it.
That's the difference, 4-2 to Bianca Wogden. That headshot.
She's done it. She is a world champion.
And she looks like she's surprised that it actually she scored that. She's in shock. She's actually in shock. She didn't realise that she'd won that match, I don't think.
She's looking to her boyfriend, Aaron, in the final. I'm in the crowd.
Referee calling her to put the headgear back on. She's celebrating there. And yes, it's the declaration. Bianca Wogden of Great Britain is world champion. For a great match at the end there. It looked like it was over for Bianca after that appeal failed. But she stayed composed. She shot high. She scored the headshot. Gwares Epang devastated at the outcome of that match. She's on all kneeling down. Bianca Wogden flies the Union flag to celebrate becoming Great Britain's world champion.
Very, very happy, obviously. She was devastated when she took that injury in China. She thought that was her.
She's actually spinning her coach around there. She actually picked him up and spun him round.
Yeah, she thought her Rio Olympic ambitions are over. She was worried she was going to drop too many points. But all the points she's lost in that period, she's just gained back. That's 120 ranking points. She's the European champion. She's the world champion. And she staked her claim to be in Rio.
There's the headshot that made all the difference. 3 points. Turned it around. Then the two Kyungos again. What an amazing turnaround in the last closing seconds of the final. Gwadys Apang from France will be devastated that she hasn't made it a third world championship. But Bianca Wogden, so brave to overcome that injury with it could potentially have been career finishing. Definitely could have been career devastating, but she's come back. She's European champion and now world champion. Can she add Olympic champion in 2016? That'll be the next goal for Bianca Wogden of Great Britain. That's the thing about the scoring system in Taekwondo. She was behind. It looked like he was going the French woman's way. Gwadys looked like she's going to have a third world title, and then that one kick made all the difference. Bianca Wogden of Great Britain, world champion. Again, we're going to see the presentation of medals and awards, and that'll be followed by the final of the minus 54 kilogram division. Those final results there. Ivanova from Russia, the 2013 world champion. Gwadys Apang from France, the world champion in 2011 and 2009. What a pedigree, some amazing players. Not forgetting Nafi Akuz from Turkey, who was a world student champion. Bianca Wogden, European champion and now world champion. See our cameraman get a picture of Bianca's boyfriend, also European champion.
Yeah.
Aaron Cook, somebody you know very well there, Luke.
Yeah, obviously we'll play on Monday in the minus 80 kilo category.
Gonna be trying to emulate the success of his girlfriend.
I hope so. They're so competitive.
The medals will be presented.
So I hope this really pushes Aaron on forward as well. He's now chosen to represent Moldova.
President of the Philippine Association, a council member, Sun Hon Chung, was the head of the World Championships way back in 1995. So he knows all about organizing and running these events. And he's making the awards as a WTF World Taekwondo Federation Council member. Nafi Akuz, bronze medal from Turkey. She's got a tremendous future ahead of her. Local girl, Olga Ivanova, former world champion, adds the bronze medal. Still only 21 years of age. The veteran Gladys Ipong from France, settling this time for silver medal.
And the gold medal. 10 seconds of victory. She's going to be bitterly disappointed.
Snatched away, but you all credit.
There's a very happy girl.
Bianca Wogden from Great Britain. President of the Philippine Taekwondo Association having to stand on the podium himself to award the medal. Like we say, what an amazing result, especially after that injury in China. It was devastating. She was on the ring. She twisted the knee. She tried to carry on. We saw that tragic movement as she tried to stand up and the leg collapsed underneath her. We're so worried that that would mark the end of her career, but she's come back fighting and she's now European and world champion. Congratulations, Bianca Wogden.
That'll do her ranking a lot of good. Obviously, she dropped down from what was quite a strong position before she took that injury, and 120 ranking points will push her straight back up, challenging for that top six place, automatic qualification. Yeah, I think she's looking
Ladies
towards Aaron in the crowd somewhere.
For the national
world champion, Bianca Wogden of Great Britain.
Дамы и господа, звучит гимн Великобритании. Мы просим вас встать.
Ladies and gentlemen, please congratulate our medalists and the new WTF World Champion.
World Female Heavyweight Champion in the plus 73 female division. Bianca Wogden of Great Britain claims the title here at the Traktor Arena in Chelyabinsk, Russia. An amazing achievement, an amazing group of athletes. What a collection. Look at this smile there, she's over the moon, and rightfully so. Well, coming up is the male, minus 54 kilogram division. World champion Kim Tae-hoon from Korea against Stanislav Denisov from Russia. You can see there in the holding area from our position. Bianca Wogden now just leaving the podium after quite a lot of photographs. We're going through to the mix zone now for interviews, some testing, and then hopefully out to celebrate. So two world champions. Lim Gyeongbyol in the minus 53 kilogram division for Korea, and Bianca Wogden in the plus 73 kilogram division for Great Britain. That's the two female divisions sorted out. We have our final match of the evening. Can the Russian, Denislav Stanislav, take the gold for Russia against the current world champion, Kim Tae-hoon? See if you can see them in the holding area. Possibly we'll see some muskets again. To the Russian fans waiting for Stanislav Denisov, the hope of a gold medal, and he'll be up against Tae-hoon Kim of Korea, the current world champion, an Asian Games champion. Impressive results in the Grand Prix series, taking gold in Suzhou, China, and then bronze in the final in Querétaro, Mexico, in December of last year. So definitely on paper, Kim Tae-hyun, the favorite. But by far the favorite in this arena is Stanislav Denisov. The local dignitaries, and we've got a message from the British Taekwondo president Adrian Tranter has contacted us in the commentary box. Say the whole of Great Britain want a massive shout out for the new world champion Bianca Wogden. Everybody's going crazy over there. Bianca Wogden of Liverpool, the new hero for Liverpool, maybe making up for the retirement of soccer star Steven Gerrard, who just finished today. We're back to business now here at the Traktor Arena in Chelyabinsk, Russia, in the minus 54 kilogram division. In the holding area, Stanislav Denisov of Russia, Tae-hyun Kim of Korea. I think this crowd's excited enough as it is without the mascots. Raising them up into a frenzy. Russia versus Korea. Host nation versus the founding nation. What promises to be a great final. Referees are about to take position. Okay, Luke, your call. What's your predictions for this match?
Well, my predictions always seem to be wrong.
And that's not true in the slightest.
I want to see a Russian victory, so I'm going to tip a Korean victory.
I really, really understand where you're coming from. The Russians have been such tremendous hosts. They've had so many players get to the semi-finals so far in this World Championships. The hopes have been dashed. Probably the best chance on paper was Olga Ivanova, the current world champ, well, the former world champion, current until this evening. Stanislav Denisov, probably not one of the stronger members of the team, though a great athlete as he's proven to get to this final.
Yeah, he probably wasn't one of the favourites of the Russian team. They're such a strong team coming into this championships. Great hopes on Albert Gorn and Alexei Denisenko that, unfortunately for them, didn't pick up that gold medal. But can we see Denisov do it here tonight?
But Denisenko was amazing last night in that final with Servet Tazagol of Turkey. Very, very close match, right to the end. And now, can Denisov match that performance and go one better and take the gold against the current world champion, Kim Tae-hyun from Korea? On paper, Kim Tae-hyun, a clear favourite. in this arena, the Traktor Arena in Chelyabinsk in Russia. The favorite is very clearly Stanislav Denisov.
Well, on paper, probably you could probably argue tonight that on paper, two of the favorites have already been turned over. So can we have a hat trick and have a Russian victory?
It would be very nice for Russia. The hosts, they put so much effort into this. Like I said on previous evenings, we arrived in the middle of the night, and yet the mascots and the supporters, the volunteers were there to give us a warm welcome. Every road sign between the airport and the arena was plastered with the signage for the World Taekwondo Championships. Russia spared no expense, they spared no effort to make this event a success. And it would be so right if Denisov could take the gold medal for them. But he's got the formidable Kim Tae-yun to face. Now, Kim Tae-yun did not take the gold medal in the World Finals of the Grand Prix Series in Querétaro, Mexico, as expected, so it's an upset then. Can that happen again? Stanislav Denisov of Russia. In blue, Kim Tae-yun, Korea. In red. Referee from Morocco, Tariq Benradi, wanting to impress, do a good job, not only for the sake of the athletes to give us a great match, but also to improve his chances of selection for Rio 2016. One more check on the PSS. Last time this evening. And Kung Yi. Great respect there to the coaches and the fellow athletes with a handshake and bow. And we're underway for the final match of this evening's session. The male minus 54 kilogram division. Denisov from Russia in blue, Kim in red. Nice back kick in reverse there. Good start.
Good start from both athletes. Both athletes already tried back kicks each, but no points on the scoreboard as yet.
Listen to that crowd go wild. Punching attempt by Denisov, seeking to think to try and influence the judges. They're having none of it at this stage. Nice kick to the body by Korea, registers just short. Nice punch there by the Korean. A little bit short range to be in consideration of scoring. Plenty of activity in this first round. Back kick attempt by the Korean. Not quite as fast or as powerful as the one we saw by the French woman in the semi-final. Guadalupe, nice counter back kick by Russia. It registers, but again, just light of scoring.
Seconds to go in this first round. Whether we're going to see a point on the scoreboard, or whether we'll go and level. Hasn't been quite the tense affair, as in a standoff. Both players been very active.
That's what we want to see. We want to see this proactivity. Korea goes high there. Nice movement. Another counter back kick by Denisov. It's only a matter of time before he gets through there.
And a back kick spin 180. That was a nice piece of skill there from Russia. No points. Not quite hitting the threshold.
They are impacting, though. You can see the green numbers at the bottom of the scoreboard. So the points are impacting. So it's only a matter of time before we see some points on the board. That's the end of the first round. Nil-nil, plenty of activity, plenty of attempts, high-level skill.
They have to hit a 26 in terms of power to number ratio. They're just hitting just under that. A couple of hits at 23 and 24. They need to hit a 26 to register a point.
See team physio doctor massaging the legs. Just remember that they actually competed in four matches yesterday. They've had a full day for that lactic acid to build up, for the stiffness to come into the muscles, and now they're here again in the final. If there is any impediment by competing day after, we haven't seen it here in this match, or indeed the previous final matches. Second round now, about to get underway. We're holding that centre ground. Stepping up off the front leg, Denisov tries the same. Referee quick to come into the middle of them. Still waiting for that elusive first point. Russia has to be careful with the holding. There's no points going on the board. Could end up with the Kyungo.
Nice exchange there from both athletes.
Denisov tries to punch over the top. Needs to be more accurate to score.
First point goes Korea's way. Front leg.
Tries again for the same technique. Goes high. And he scores a second one to the body. Nice counter attempt by Denisov, but not quite in range. Taehyung Kim's got a 2-point lead now.
Just going over halfway this final. Those 2 points will help the reigning world champion Kim Taehyung just settle down. Feel a little bit more in control.
Denisov again trying spinning and working that back. He needs to be careful, doesn't get counted on the way in.
Nice back kick there from Korea. And another one in return from Russia. And he tried it too many times and Korea's tagged him over the top.
He did put him off though, he just tried it again. He's getting caught on the way in now. Denisov, he needs to focus. The end of this round's due in 12 seconds and he'll need that to get his thoughts together, listen to what his coach has to say, change his tactics, because he's the spinning back kicks and not getting the points where he needs. He's 5 points down at the end of the second round.
And he's not just quite finding that sweet spot on the pad. Maybe Korea's just blocking him off, taking the sting out of the shot. But Kim Taehyung is in control now, but that could swing very fast as we've seen.
Well, 5 points hasn't meant that much in the semi-finals of the 54 kilogram division. And, you know, a couple of headshots, a few spinning kicks, and it could all change all over again. In the lead over Stanislav Denisov from Russia. The supporters desperate for the first gold medal. That's a good back kick. Didn't score. Denisov tried a few too many of those. Got picked off a couple of times. Be interested to see if he changes his tactics here. Pressure will be on him now. Kim will be protecting that lead. Might try and spoil. Let's see. 5-0 to Taehyung Kim of Korea.
Still sticking with that back kick, being tagged again and again.
He's 7-0. He's got caught. He needs to be doing something different. Maybe a combination rather than doing a single back kick. Lead in and then do it. Coach going to work to the script and do that then.
Strong check from Korea. Brings it up to 8-0.
Denisov needs to do something now. Kim's taking control. Kyungo for Denisov.
8-0. Could the painting already be on the wall? Could we still
tries a punch, but it's too close.
Believe and rush up.
Kim Tae-young in a dominant position now. 8 points to nil. Tries his own back. Oh, a tremendous headshot. No score. No appeal by the Korean coach. At this stage, he's happy with it as it is.
Keeps trying with those back kicks. Maybe he's just trying to send it high. He keeps sending it into the body. He's not finding the pad.
He's not getting through Kim's defences at all.
It's
he's slipping the kicks.
It's another point. He's picked one there, though. It should be 9-3.
He's calling in that while they adjust the score there.
So with 45 seconds to go, Russia's brought it back to a 6-point deficit. Slim chance. He's got to keep pushing. Still believe.
The crowd are quite pleased about that. 3 points. It's the first one that's got through. Tries to spin and again comes in.
Korea's going to play for a face kick, I think.
I think he tried just then, didn't he? But it didn't quite impact. In fact, the Korean coach is making the appeal that it did impact. 3 points. 3 points to indicate 3 points face. So video replay. Just over 30 seconds remaining in this third round. Let's hope this process doesn't take too long. It did seem to take place right in front of the video review jury camera. So that's the spinning by Denisov. Didn't look to be any impact there.
If that was the kick.
If that was the one that is appealing, Denisov gets it well out of the way, didn't he? He's nowhere near if that was the kick. But remember, the video review judges don't get the same image that we do. They might be looking at something different. There's a, you can just see in the top left-hand corner of the screen there, the actual video review screen. It does seem to be the same kick that is appealing. Scores 9-3. It's rejected. Stays 9-3. Just over 30 seconds remaining in this last round. Denisov comes spinning in straight away to Kyungo. Korea gets another point.
And lost the point in that exchange as well.
At this stage now, it looks like a silver medal for Denisov. But it's still going up for the headshots. Slipping the punches, just making them miss. Covering to the middle. Goes high. Excellent work rate by Tae-young Kim. Kim's not spoiling it by inactivity. He's going for the kicks himself. He's stopping anything. He's got an answer for anything that Denisov throws at him.
8 points.
Goes up for the headshot and scores. Takes it.
But the gap remains the same as the Russian athlete scored his spinning technique to the body. Both athletes picking up a warning.
He's just in the ring. Stays
1 second.
Kyungo.
That won't change anything. 7 points with 1 second.
Kim Tae-un of South Korea retains his world title. Stanislav Denisov made every effort imaginable and gets a well-deserved silver medal. But Tae-young Kim, the 2013 world champion, 2014 Asian Games champion, takes gold and joins an illustrious group of Koreans at double world champions. Brave attempt by Stanislav Denisov. Maybe needed to change tactics slightly. Kept on with that spinning back kick attempts in the second round. Didn't quite make enough contact. And Kim Tae-young.
Broken Russian hearts again on this fourth night of finals.
21 years of age, Kim Tae-young from South Korea, now double world champion.
Denisov applauds the Russian crowd for their support. They've been here in numbers again tonight.
So a good night for Korea. Two gold medals. One in the female, minus 53 kilogram division. Lim Gumgol. And now in the male, minus 54 kilogram division, Kim Tae-un. The other gold medal going to Great Britain. In the plus 73 kilogram division, Bianca Wogden taking the gold in an amazing match against the two-time former world champion, Gladys Epine. Great night of competition in Taekwondo. I'd like to thank Luke Cook for being with me tonight and giving us some expert advice. And despite what he said, his predictions, I think he's still well ahead over the Grand Prix series and the World Championships as we've been watching it. So thanks again for that, Luke.
Thank you for having me, Mike. It was a pleasure. I was so happy to see Bianca get what she deserves. She's worked so hard for that world title.
Indeed, and then Korea, the powerhouse, the founding country of Taekwondo, taking two of the medals tonight. What a great evening's competition. We're just waiting for the presentation now of the awards.
This is the victory ceremony for the male, minus 54 kilograms.
Мы начинаем церемонию награждения в мужской весовой категории до 54 килограмм.
Just about to have the awarding ceremony of the male, minus 54 kilogram division at the 2015 World Taekwondo Championships here in Chelyabinsk, Russia, at the impressive Tractor Arena. Strong start by the Brazilian athlete Benelton Teixeira, but wasn't enough to defeat Denisov. Ran the wrong Sawik Wahiri. Another strong, credible performance by the Thai athlete.
Silver medalist representing the Russian Federation.
So near. Stanislav Denisov, 21-year-old from Russia, made to the final but just couldn't overcome for two times now, world champion Kim Tae-hyun of Korea.
And the gold medalist, WTF world champion representing Korea, Kim Tae-hyun.
И победителем, новым чемпионом мира по тхэквондо становится спортсмен из Кореи, Ким Тэ-хун.
Please join us tomorrow for more action here at the World Taekwondo Championships and the Traktor Arena in Chelyabinsk.
Will be presented by Stanislav Mosherov, Chelyabinsk City Head.
Цветы вручения Станислав Иванович.
Presentations of awards being made by the head, the federal district that has put so much into making this event a great success. Championships just got better and better as the week's gone on. Last night we saw the legend, that is Servet Tazagul, take gold medal. Some great action tonight. Speed and skill from all the athletes, and well-deserved medalists tonight. So again, hope to see you tomorrow. Say bye from Chelyabinsk, Traktor Arena in Russia.
Please stand for the national anthem of Korea.
Дамы и господа, звучит гимн Кореи. Мы просим вас встать.
Ladies and gentlemen, please congratulate our medalist and the new WTF World Champion from Korea, Kim Tae-hyun.
Давайте еще раз поприветствуем наших медалистов и нового чемпиона мира по тхэквондо, Ким Тэ-хун.
The WTF recognizing the value of the coach by presenting him with the gold medal from Korea is Dong Kyun Hil.
Впервые в истории турнира мы также награждаем золотой медалью тренера за его неоценимую работу и труд. Дон Кьон Ким.
Thank you.
for you.